Welcome to DyKnow Cloud. Our focus in this training will be logging in, viewing real-time student activity, building a blocking plan, and viewing historical student activity data. First, log in. Access your school's DyKnow Cloud page in your favorite browser. Each school uses a different website, but they all end in dyknow.me. We recommend Google Chrome, but Firefox, Internet Explorer, and Safari all work too. If you haven't already, now is a great time to bookmark this website for quick daily access. Log in with the username and password your DyKnow project lead gave you. If you can't remember your password, simply click Forgot Password and enter your school email address. We will email you a new one. Once you're logged in, you will see the classes you teach. Your students are already enrolled. These classes and rosters match your school's student information system. Choose a class and select Start Monitoring. For the class you chose, in this case, AP History, you will see the screens of your student devices pop in on the left. Here's a tip. As a best practice for checking in on your students' activity, we recommend using Activity Tracker. On the right side of your screen, you'll see each website or application being used by your students. To access a list of which students are viewing a particular website or app, click on the name. Here are the students viewing National Geographic. We're teaching AP History, so National Geographic may be an off-task activity right now. To build a blocking plan, click the blue Modify Blocking button. This can address the off-task activity. By default, your blocking plan is allowing all, which means all websites and applications are accessible from each student's device. Start by giving your blocking plan a name. Once you've built blocking plans, they're automatically saved forever. You can access these saved blocking plans for any of the classes you teach. This is also where you'll choose a blocking plan you already built and apply it. Here's a tip. If you know your agenda for today's class, we recommend using an allow-only plan. Enter the names of the websites and applications you expect your students to be using, and this set it and forget it method will prevent any other websites or applications from being opened on the student's device while you're monitoring them with this plan. For example, allow only the websites Google Docs, Google Forms, Google Drive, and web browsers. In this plan, students will be able to access their Google Forms and Google Docs inside of any browser. If students try to access a different URL, like National Geographic, the website is inaccessible. If students try to access an application like Microsoft Word, the application is also inaccessible. To apply your plan, select the blue Enforce button located in the upper right corner. To remove your plan with one click, select Remove Blocking. Until you end your DyKnow class or remove your blocking plan, the plan stays in place. Block-only plans are great to limit a few select websites and applications. Perhaps today, your students are working in groups and the room is noisy, so listening to music isn't appropriate. Use a block-only plan to block music sites and apps, but still allow other websites and applications to load as expected on their devices. It's important to end monitoring for two reasons. If you had a blocking plan in place, the plan will be released. Also, DyKnow collects data on how students are spending their time while you're monitoring. End monitoring tells DyKnow to stop collecting data for this particular class. Now let's take a look at the data DyKnow collected during class time. Once you've ended monitoring, you're back at your DyKnow classes dashboard. Select the Class Analytics button. Visible to each teacher is a tab for each class and roster in DyKnow. Remember, these sync with your student information system. Choose the tab for the class you just taught. To see which student accessed each activity, click the blue icon to the right of the activity. From this view, you also have a shortcut to access that student's individual activity. You can change your data set by changing the name of the student and/or the date range, just use the drop-down menus along the top of Analytics. Data is saved forever, so you can access it anytime. DyKnow teachers have told us they use Analytics in the following ways. Monitor increased student productivity and accountability. Compare on and off task data with class progress. Share with other teachers the academic or instructional resources students are accessing during class. And alter your lesson plans based on the site students like to use. Thanks for joining us. Remember, you can always use the chat feature in the bottom right corner to ask us a question anytime. We almost always respond in the same day. Thanks for using DyKnow Cloud!